Yes, students, we continue with the reading of the chapter Madam Rides the Bus. What have we read in this chapter? What is the story about? It's about a little girl, Bunny. And what does she want to do? She wants to ride the bus. What preparations does she make? One is, how does she manage to save the money? She's heard from passengers coming and going how much it costs for one way, right, traveling. And so she saves money. How much does she save? 60 paisa she saves for the journey. And yes, so she also selects a time which is very convenient for her, the time when her mother has a nap, right, in the afternoon. So 1 o'clock to 4 o'clock, that is when her mother is resting. And otherwise also during the time she goes, you know, like when he goes outside and takes around in the village and all, or she keeps standing in the doorway, and so that time she finds quite convenient for her. So she's gone on the bus, right? How are the people there on the bus? How do they behave with her? Right? She doesn't like one of the lady passengers because, yes, so she has big holes in her earlobes and she's wearing ugly earrings and she had bitter juice coming out of her mouth. What about the behavior of the conductor? Yeah, the conductor was very kind and the conductor was very jovial. He was laughing at her, he was making fun at her. But yes, in a way, he was taking care of her, right? An 8-year-old girl traveling alone, right? So she wants to look outside, but she's unable to see what is there. So she stands at the seat and looks outside. And the passengers, you know, like calling her a child. And she says, no, I'm not a child. I have paid my money for my ticket, for the fare I have given. So I'm not a small child, okay? Right, so she is there like behaving like a grown-up. Now what are the things that she notices? What are the things that she sees? The blue sky and the green fields. She notices the palm trees and the distant mountains, right? So all these things that she notices, and that is what she wanted to see. What is it that people see on the way when they travel on the bus? They go from one place to another, they go to the town. What do they see on the way? And what do they see over there? So that is a curiosity, right? And how she saved money, and she would get money, you know, like, and not spend it. Even if she wanted to buy candies or she wanted to buy a balloon, and once she went to the village fair, she wanted to take a ride. She controlled herself. I am not spending money. Okay? Right. So now let us see here. The bus rolled on now, cutting across a bare landscape, now rushing through a tiny hamlet or past an odd wayside. Sometimes the bus seemed on the point of gobbling up another vehicle that was coming towards them or a pedestrian crossing the road. So right, the bus was there going on quite smoothly. Sometimes a tiny hamlet is a small village. So it would go past a small village, or there would be a shop on the road. And sometimes, you know, it seems like when you are driving and another vehicle is coming towards you, and especially when you're on a bus or something, that it seems as if it is going to come under the bus, right? Gobbling. What does gobbling mean? To eat, right? And so it seems as if this huge bus is going to eat that small vehicle, okay? That was coming towards them, or a pedestrian crossing the road. Right, you gobble up that. What is happening? Going to happen to that person? But no, somehow it passed on smoothly, leaving all obstacles safely behind. So the driver was very confident, a good driver, would not let any such thing to overcome all the what obstacles, whatever were there. For the passengers, they seemed obstacles, but the driver knew, I have to drive very carefully. I should not hurt anyone. And yes, the ride should be smooth and without any kind of mishappening. Trees came running towards them, but then stopped as the bus reached them and simply stood there, helpless for a moment, by the side of the road before rushing away in the other direction. So as you're driving on the road, you see the trees coming towards you. But when you stop, so the trees also there. And then afterwards, when you pass that destination, the trees left far behind, right? So it seems as if they're sprinting along with you. The trees also running along with you, doesn't it? Yes, it seems like that. Suddenly, Bully clapped her hands in glee. Yes, happiness. She's so happy. A young cow, tail high in the air, was running very fast, right in the middle of the road, right in front of the bus. What did Bully see? She saw this cow running on the road, right? Its tail high in the air. It's very excited. It's quite disturbed, red and caught in the traffic, running here and there. The bus slowed to a crawl, and the driver sounded his horn loudly again and again. So the bus started crawling, slowed down, and the driver blowing its horn that the cow should get up off the road. But the more he honked, the more frightened the animal became, and the faster it galloped, always right in front of the bus. So the animal became very nervous, did not know what to do, which direction to go. And when the driver was honking the horn, the cow started running in flight of the bus. Okay, right. So this is one something very strange, and Bully is laughing at this situation. Right. Somehow this was very funny to Bully. She laughed and laughed until there were tears in her eyes. So she's like very excited by this whole condition. What is happening here? This cow coming and running in front of the bus. Something she had never seen before. So she's clapping her hands and she's laughing and tears coming out of her eyes. Hey lady, haven't you laughed enough? Called the conductor. Better save some for tomorrow. Who's the lady here? Bully. And earlier the conductor had called her madam. Right? So now he's calling her lady, madam. Right? Better save some for tomorrow. Don't laugh so much. Okay? At last, the cow moved off the road, and soon the bus came to a main road crossing. A speck of a train could be seen in the distance, growing bigger and bigger as it drew near. So the train, like a dot in the distance, and then becoming bigger and bigger, and the train passing the railway crossing. Then it rushed past the crossing gate with a tremendous roar and rattle shaking. Lots of noise it's making, and how it seemed that the bus was also shaking. Then the bus went on and passed the train station. From there, it traversed a busy, well-laid out shopping street and entered a wider thoroughfare. So what's a thoroughfare? A public road, right? Lots of traffic over there. People coming. Buses coming and going. Such bright looking shops. What glittering displays of clothes and other merchandise, such big crowds. So all of a sudden, from the road, from the trees on the road, from one small shop or one small village, after crossing the railway station, where does the bus has come to the village. Okay, right? And yes, coming to the shopping street, and Bully is so excited to see these bright shops with so many goods hanging. And yes, what else was there? There was a big crowd, such big crowds. Struck dumb with wonder, right? So she's very surprised. She's never seen like anything like this. Bully gaped at everything. She's staring at everything. Then the bus stopped, and everyone got off except her. Then the bus stopped because of this, you know, like the destination. They reached the town. Everybody got off except Bully. Hey lady, said the conductor, aren't you ready to get off? This is as far as the 30 paise takes. 30 paise takes, yana tumne. Now we need to get off. No, Bully said, I'm going back on this same bus. She took another 30 paise from her pocket and handed the coins to the conductor. Because this is what her plan was. Did she plan on getting off the bus? No, smart girl. Because she's never been to the town before, she might get lost, right? And how is she going to come back home? So she had decided, I'll just travel on the bus, I'll just take a ride on the bus, and I will not get down. So she has 30 paise ready. She says, no, I have come back also, I have 50 paise more. And the conductor is a little worried. Why is something the matter? No, nothing's the matter. I just felt like having a bus ride. That's all. She said, nothing wrong. I want to have a bus ride. Don't you want to have a look at the signs now that you're here? So she was very excited to see the market. She's very excited to see the shop around. So he said, if you want to see, go to the market. all by myself. Oh, I'd be much too afraid. Look at it so ironically here. She's been all by myself alone. No, I'll be very scared. And she's managed to travel alone, but she's afraid of going to the market to go. Why? Because she's never been there before. Such big crowds are there. She will not maybe get lost or she might not find a way. Greatly amused by the girl's way of speaking, the conductor said, but you weren't afraid to come in the bus. Akhilya answered, no, you weren't scared. Ram, why are you scared of going to the market? Nothing to be afraid about that. And the bus, I'm safe. I know where the bus is going to go. I know that, yes. But if I go outside, there's a chance I might get lost. Well, then why not go to the store over there and have something to drink? Nothing to be afraid of about that. Oh, no, I won't do that. Well, then let me bring you a cold drink. He said, you can get down, have something to drink because it's time for the bus to move. No, I don't have enough money. Just give me my ticket, that's all. So she doesn't have extra money to buy a drink for herself. It'll be my treat and cost you nothing. And not cost you anything. So I'll give I'll pay for the cold drink. You can have a drink. She says, no, I don't want to have any. No, no, she said firmly. Please, no. And of course, we should not accept things from strangers, right? So very responsible she is. The conductor shrugged, and they waited until it was time for the bus to begin the return journey. Again, there were 20 passengers. So it wasn't crowded. Yes, come on, let's go to the questions. Let me hear the answers from you all. How did Malli save up money for her first journey? Was it easy for her? How did she save money? Who's going to give me the answer? Yes? So she did not buy candies and peppermints or balloons. She did not take rides in the fair. And so she was able to save the money, right? Was it easy for her? No, it's a very difficult for a child to say no to temptation. What did Malli see on the way that made her laugh? What did she see? Made her laugh. She was clapping her hands and she was laughing so much when she saw the cow running on the road. Yes, and the cow was quite confused which direction to go. And so she just kept on laughing. Why did she get off at the bus station? Because she didn't have any plans. She just wanted to ride the bus. She did not want to go into the busy marketplace. So chances of her getting lost, right? Why did Malli want to go to the stall and have a drink? Because she did not have money. What does this tell you about her? Otherwise, also tells us that she is quite responsible and she does not want to get off the bus because she feels safe on the bus. Right? Yeah, so you people have not given me any answers. I am the one giving answers for you all. Right? Hope you are going to write down these answers in your notebooks. Won't your mother be looking for you? The conductor asked when he gave the girl the ticket. No, no one will be looking for me, she said. The bus started again and there were the same sights. So right, the bus started and the same sights, the thing which you saw on the way to the town, now on the way back also the same sights. The bus conductor is worried, you know, like, would your mother be worried? You've been away for a long time, right? So she would be looking for you. But she knows that at this time, mother is resting. She would not know what her daughter is up to. Malli wasn't bored on the like in the slightest and greeted everything the same excitement she felt the same first time. She was not bored at all. And again, she's clapping and enjoying the ride and looking at the sights around her. But suddenly, she saw a young cow lying dead by the just where it had been struck by some fast moving vehicle. Isn't that the same cow that ran in front of the bus on a trip to town? She asked the conductor. The conductor nodded and she was overcome with silence. What had been a lovable, beautiful creature just a little while ago, how now suddenly lost its charm and its life and looked so horrible, so frightening as it lay there. Legs spread eagled, a fixed stare in its lifeless eyes, blood. So what had been, right, a few Hours ago, a lively creature full of life, running on the road here and there, and now it's lying dead on the side of the road. And yes, here, what has Avali learned about sadness, about death? That it is not always that, yes, life is going to be full of happy moments. You're going to come across sad moments also. The must smote on the memory of the dead cow now haunted her, dampening her enthusiasm. Enthusiasm, excitement, right? And her thought is coming back again. The sight that she saw. And imagine a little girl seeing that sight, right? It's coming to her mind again and again. She no longer wanted to go out there, afraid of what she might see now, right? Because she's seen a dead cow, she does not want to look out. She sat thus, glued to her seat, until the bus reached her village at 3:40. She stood up and stretched herself. Then she turned to the conductor and said, "Well, sir, I hope to see you again." So very good mannered girl. "Okay, madam," he answered her, smiling. "Whenever you feel like a bus ride, come and join us. And don't forget to bring your fare." She laughed and jumped down from the bus. Then away she went, running straight for home. Right? So yes, the bus conductor laughing at her. "Don't forget to bring your fare." She's very particular about that. She'll never ride without a ticket. When she entered her house, she found her mother awake and talking to one of Balin's aunts, the one on South Street. This aunt was a real chatterbox, never closing her mouth while she started. So when she went home, her mother was awake, her mother was not resting, right? And she was talking to one of the ladies, right? One of Balin's aunts who lived in South Street. "And where have you been?" said her aunt when Balin came in. Her aunt is a big chatterbox talking and maybe she wants lots of information. Said her aunt when Balin came in. She spoke very casually, not expecting her reply. So Vali just smiled and her mother and aunt went on with their conversation. "Yes, you're right," her mother said. "So many things in our midst and in the world outside. How can we possibly know about everything? And even when we do know something, we often can't understand it completely, can we? Why did Vali take the bus ride? Why did she go on the bus? She wanted to see things. She wanted to see what people saw on their ride. Where did people go to? She wanted to learn about this big world. And she did learn a few lessons. She saw beauty. She saw sadness. There were happy moments. There were sad moments. And right, this is what her mother is talking about, right? There are so many things here in the world outside. And we can't do everything. But yes, we can't understand everything. We need to be like water. We think that we need to learn so many things. We need to be aware of so many things, but it's not possible. It's a big world. "Oh, yes," breathed Vali. "What?" asked her mother. "What's that you say?" "Oh," said Vali, "I was just agreeing with what you said about things happening without our knowledge. So many things happening. See, I'm sitting at home and I didn't know that there were so many outside, right? So people traveling by the bus, seeing so many things every day. I didn't know that this was there outside in the world." "Just a chit of a girl she is," said her aunt. "And yet, look how she pokes her nose into a conversation. She's such a little girl, 8-year-old, and look at her, poking her nose, just as though she were a grown lady." Vali smiled to herself. She didn't want them to understand her smile. But then there wasn't much chance of that. Was there? Right? So she's smiling to herself and she's wondering what her aunt and mother were going to think of that smile. But she did not want them to understand because they would not understand. Vali is not a little girl anymore. She's been out. She's seen, you know, like beautiful sights. She's seen the world outside, right? And yes, she knows so many things, which her mother, her aunt, they would not understand, right? Okay, yes, so nice chapter.
Any doubts? Any questions? You have? You have any doubts or any questions here? Students? No? Is it clear? So, right, what was Bali's behavior? You know, why she was so excited and laughing? What changed that? Yes? What changed her laughter? Tell me, please. What are the things that she saw that made her stop laughing? Yes? You can give the answer. I can unmute you all. What changed her happiness into sadness? What changed her happiness into sadness? Tell me. What was that? Yes? Seeing the dead cow. Yes, seeing the dead. Her mother was so big, so she became sad. But right, her mother did not ask her any questions that where were you and all, because she knew it was a habit, you know, when her mother would be napping and she would be standing in the doorway, watching people coming and going. Sometimes she would take like roaming in the village outside. So her mother was not very surprised, because her mother had never expected her little girl to do this. She did not know about her great adventure. What made Bali sad? The death of the cow, right? It made her realize that life is full of happy moments as well as sad moments. That a few hours ago, a creature that was full of life, what has happened? It's lying on the side of the road, right? Yes, here, okay. Yes, she saw a dead cow. Now, just tell me one thing here. Do you think what Bali did was correct? She went on a ride. Yeah? Do you think she did the right thing? So, I am going to... ask you all questions. So let me see now. Yes, please just tell me here, all of you. What about it? Do you think Bali did the right thing by traveling alone? Let's have a little discussion. Raise your hand, I'll admit you. Give me the answer. Should Bali have traveled alone on the bus? So she was lucky enough, you know. Yes. Was it the right thing to do? Was quite a big risk that she took. Yes? Okay. Right? And she took a big risk traveling all alone and traveling there with a little girl. And yes, here. But she was lucky enough that the conductor was there. Very nice, very understanding, very cooperative. Okay? And so her journey very smoothly and very nice. But otherwise, as you know, like youngsters, it's very risky. You know, you move off and all of a sudden you feel, I won't go to that place and you go on your own. Right? Without informing your parents, it is not a nice thing. So we appreciate when you wanted to know about the outside world. She wanted to see what is there and she decided, I'm going to do it myself. Okay, right. So maybe if she had expressed this desire to her parents, they would have taken her, right? And yes, so they would have even seen the town also. She might have been able to go to the shops in the market and see those places also, isn't it? But here it was right, something that is not good. It is not a responsible act on the part of women. Okay. Right. Yes, here. Yeah. Let's come to the other questions here. What was Bali's deepest desire? Find words and phrases in the story that tell you. What is Bali's deepest desire? She wanted to ride on the bus. She wanted to see the things that people saw, right? Where they went every day, they came back here. What was it that they saw and what they noticed? How did Bali plan her bus ride? What did she find out about the bus? And how did she see up the fare? This we have discussed. How did she find out by the people's conversations? For the people who used to pass on the street, did they talk about it, right? And so she came to know about the bus timings. Yes, what kind of a person is Bali? So just look at these sentences from the text and we'll come to know about her. Yes, she is a brave girl. What are the qualities of Pallu? Let us just discuss that. Yes? Think about it, okay? So what is your homework for today? You'll be going through all these questions. And we'll be discussing them tomorrow. Is it clear? Yes, all of you? Right. So we'll continue with the discussion of the question answers tomorrow.